kids. I'm Mr. Tim.
And I'm Miss Gina. And we're so happy to be with you today.
Oh, we couldn't see you. We're so excited to be with you today for today's AG Kids lesson. Hey, can you see us okay? It's no fun when you can't see things clearly.
Mm-mm. Some people in our family need to wear glasses. And some people in our family wear contacts. And even other people in our family don't need either.
Let's see how good your eyes are. Let's go! Alright kids, let's see how good your vision is. Let's see if you can read these words. What does that word say? Cat. That's right. Good job. How about this word? Can you read what the paper says? Say it loud so I can hear you. Apple. Very good. Good job. How about this word? It's getting harder now. It's pretty far away. Can you read it? It says, jump! Good job. How about this word? You really have to strain to see it. Come in closer, maybe. Can you see it now? The word is see. Nice. Hey, you know what? This reminds me of a story in the Bible where Jesus healed a man's vision. He didn't just make blurry vision clearer. He gave sight to a blind man. Let's go to God's word in John chapter 9 to see more.
Jesus was walking with his disciples when he saw a man who had been born blind. The disciples asked, "Teacher, why was this man born blind? Did this happen because of his sin or his parents' sin?" Jesus answered, "Neither his sin nor his parents' sin caused this. This man was born blind so that people could see God's power through him. Jesus would be on earth for a short time, so he healed people to show what God is like. Jesus said, "While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." Then Jesus spit on the ground and made mud. He put the mud on the eyes of the man who was blind. "Go and wash in the pool of Siloam," Jesus instructed. The man went and washed.
Wow.
When he came back, he could see. The man's neighbors were amazed. They took the man to the religious leaders and they asked him how he was healed. "A man put mud on my eyes. I washed, and now I can see," he said. The religious leaders were upset because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath again. They did not want to believe that Jesus could give sight to people who were blind. Over and over again, the man who was healed told the religious leaders what happened. The man believed Jesus must have come from God. But the religious leaders threw the man out of the synagogue. Jesus came to the man again and asked, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" The man answered, "Tell me who he is so I can believe in him." "You have already seen him," Jesus replied. "The Son of Man is talking to you now." The man said, "I believe, Lord." And he worshiped Jesus. Our sin makes us unable to see the truth about God. Jesus came as a light in a dark world. He came to give us sight, true understanding of God and his kingdom. Those who trust in Jesus see who he is and worship him.
Wow, guys, wasn't that an amazing story? The best thing about that story is that it's true. Jesus was just walking with his disciples when he saw a blind man who had been blind since birth. And his disciples asked him if sin had caused this blindness, sin of the man or sin of someone else.
Jesus explained that the reason the man was born blind wasn't because of sin. Mm-mm. It was because God wanted to show off his power when he healed that man's vision.
God is so strong. He is mighty to save. Not only did Jesus heal the man's blindness, but he gave him faith to trust him and worship him. God is so good.
Why did God create people? Well, God created people so they could love him and worship him and bring him glory.
Yeah, for sure. Well, guys, let's take a look at our memory verse. We know you've been working on this for a few weeks, but it's a big one. It's such an important one, guys. Okay, so let's go over it again.
We got this.
So we're going to take it a few chunks at a time, and we're going to read Isaiah 53, 4 through 5. You can repeat after me. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Good job. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted.
Good.
But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities.
Well done, kids.
Last one, repeat after me. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. You guys did great. Good job.
Points us to the true hero of the story. Mm-hmm. The blind man's story, my personal story, your story too. In a way, we're all born blind, dead in our sins. We need Jesus to open our eyes to the truth of the gospel. Yeah. Thanks to what God has done for us, we can live a life full of joy and thankfulness.
Yeah. Well, let's see if you were really listening to the story we heard about today. Are you ready? I've got three questions for you. Here we go. How did Jesus heal the blind man?
Oh, he put glasses on him, right?
No. I bet you remember though, right? Jesus took spit and dirt and made mud. He wiped it on the man's eyes and then washed it off. That's what he did.
Amazing.
Really. Okay, question number two. Why do you think Jesus calls himself the light of the world? I would really encourage you guys to talk with your parents about this question in particular after this video. I think that Jesus lights up his word and allows us to understand it. You know, it's really hard to do things in the dark. We need light to see the way. Okay, guys, last question. Are you ready? How can we be given spiritual sight? Not physical sight, spiritual sight. Well, you know, we can't earn our salvation. We can't do enough good works. We can't follow enough rules. Salvation is given to us freely in faith. Isn't that amazing? Amazing grace. God gives us new life, and he also gives us the Holy Spirit to help us live a life growing to know, love, and follow him. Isn't that so good? I'm so thankful.
God is amazing.
Well, guys, we're so glad that you joined us for today's AG Kids lesson.
Thank you, Mary, very much for being here. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for all your goodness and your grace. Thank you for the love that you've given us so freely. Mm. Please open our eyes to your goodness, mm-hmm. And help us bring glory to you all of our days. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Bye, kids.
Bye.